strategies for not being mad at the elite, not holding grudges at people that have more than we do. Strategies for just not being jealous, you know? And strategies for understanding why the elite or the powerful are doing what they're doing right now, okay? There's a strategy, okay? The universe has love. There's up all the way to the top. There's bad people and good people. But bad is, you know, how do we define bad? And how do we define good? So, you know, it's all kind of perception and opinion, okay? So, if you send hate and fear up to the people that run stuff, you might get it right back, you know? If you just send love and support, okay, get the job done, come on, we got this, you know? That might help, you know? They got these faces of people that are supposed to be bad people in our public opinion, you know? Like Gary Gensler is supposed to be a bad guy. Of course, he signed up to be a bad guy. But what if he's a good guy? We don't know. How do we know what's even going on behind the scenes? Unless you're sitting there in the meetings, you have no idea what's going on. So why are we getting mad? Why are we letting the perception of reality that they hand down to us, why are we letting that dictate and control our psyche and our actions and our behaviors? You know? We gotta figure out stuff on our own. We gotta do what the fuck we wanna do. We gotta just, you know, if your brain is all logical and messing with you and overthinking it, overanalyzing it, you gotta go with your gut. You gotta go downstairs. You know, people say there's emotional intelligence, the gut, you know, and there's logical intelligence, you know, two lobes of the brain, left, right. You know, I think the right is emotional and the left is logical. And that's how I remembered it, left logical. And then there's a connection between the two. Okay. Okay, baby. So, wave hi.
Hi.
Aw, good girl. Good girl. So, I mean, just pack some bags and just sit and wait and get your popcorn ready. You know, watch the show. You know, make sure you have water stored up, you know, like 5 gallon jugs of water, and then Brita water filters to filter water, because if the water sits for a while, it goes bad and stuff, you know. Water is the most main important thing, okay? And then food's next. So water, make sure you got your water set up, okay? So 5 gallon jugs at Walmart, I mean, you bought way stupider shit at Walmart. You know you have, trust me. You know? What? Hello, girl. Go, baby. Okay, so stock up, protect yourselves. Put a little in digital assets, gold, silver, and freaking, they're gonna rock the ship. They're gonna freaking, you know, FTX, I don't know. I'm not saying hold all your money on the sidelines. They're telling everybody to hold all their money on the sidelines. We haven't experienced the worst debt dip yet. I think that's bullshit. I think we're bouncing off the bottom right now. So I think right now I'm buying, you know what I'm saying? I'm not like holding all my money on the sideline, waiting for it to get lower, you know, because then all of a sudden when it goes up, you have half your money on the sideline, which you could have been in that half of money could have been a way more. I'm telling you, it doesn't matter. It's not relevant at this point. If you make like a couple extra shares or not, because you waited a couple extra days, it does not matter. We are in the time zone. We are in the period where you need to just get in now and then shut the fuck up and sit back and enjoy your life. These traders, dude, These traders are going crazy. They're looking at the charts every day during Christmas and stuff like that. Sorry, but it's controlling their mind, their soul, and their body, and every movement that they have is controlled by these stupid fucking charts that are manipulated by big institutions and stuff. XRP, Ripple is, for a long time, and right now, they're suppressing the price. They're manipulating the price. They're buying, but they're also selling. You know, they're just trying to keep that price stable because they don't want it to freaking spike up. You know, because they want it to be low for their buddies to get in. And they want to control when it goes way down. You know what I'm saying? If there's going to be another dip, like a 5-10 cent dip, like really, who gives a fuck? Like that's the matter of like a couple more hundred XRP. Like seriously, does that really fucking matter? Okay, just get your fucking couple thousand XRP in your fucking wallet and you're good. You're good, seriously. It's like, you know, time travel back in the day. Bitcoin, you know, get your 100,000, get a couple thousand Bitcoin, sit back and relax, wait for the ride. And when you're trading, when you're just, come on, guys. Dude spends every day. He's cool. But XRP Future Millionaire, come on, shout out. But come on, dude, every day you're talking about trend lines and just like all this shit that you're just watching the ocean waves crashing down. But the thing is, it's not natural. The elite are controlling those waves and how they crash down. And you're sitting there just like stressing about it. Oh my God, the wave's going to crash down. Oh my God, the wave's going to come up. Come on, get the fuck out of there. That's a fucking mental trap. That is fucking with your mind. That is fucking with your mind, your soul, and your body. That's stealing your energy. And that's fucking forcing you to be a fucking little cog in their machine. Fucking brainwashed little cog to their charts. Dude, you guys got to get the fuck out of the charts for a second. Just take a breath. Get a little oxygen. Stop looking at the fucking charts every day. And you might be like, holy fuck. There's actually better shit that I could be looking at. You know, it's gonna fucking click. The charts have fucking manipulated and fucking hypnotized and fucking controlled your fucking mental faculties. And you feel so smart because you learn all this shit that no one else knows. And when you have all these terms and language and shit that you know that no one else knows, it makes you feel like a god. It makes you feel so smart. But like maybe there's a reason why the general public don't give a fuck. Because in their heart, in their instinct, they're good energy, their like past lives, their gods or God, or you know, their like celestial ancestors, their good loving energy or whatever is not leading them towards just fucking being hypnotized and focused and distracted by little fucking charts that elite, some of them, they don't keep themselves well. They're these fat motherfuckers that like to fuck children and they're fucking making the shit go up and down. Some of them are cool. We got the cool ones fighting against the bad ones, okay? But the bad ones, I think right now, are just manipulating shit to go up and down. And you guys are fucking hypnotized by it, just like I'm hypnotized by this fucking screen. What? What, baby? Say hi. Go that way? Okay, yeah. Go. Go, girl.
Go, 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 go.
You want to get up in there? Okay. All right, so hold on a second. So I guess this video is more like a psychological upkeep, like a protection of your mental health in this situation where society is trying to hypnotize and control us. And I'm not immune, guys, okay? I will be judged. What, Olivia? Shit, what? What do you want? What? Cough drop? You want a cough drop? Alright, Olivia, cough drop? Okay, let me finish my thing, dude. Come on. Okay. Hypnotism. We're in the Matrix. Total mind control. Total manipulation. We are manipulating ourselves, and I think, like, we allow it when we ingest caffeine and drugs and substances. That lets the negative energy come in and just, like, play us like a puppet. You know, if we're meant to be sad for a while, we might have to just sit down and be sad. We might just have to grieve. We might just have to take that hit for a while. If that's our destiny for a little bit, if that's what we have to do to get out of this funk, we may just have to fucking sit down and take some pain. You know, everything you don't want to think about with your mom and dad, all the struggles, when you fucking run to the coffee in the morning, that just jumbles up your brain and makes you forget. Just totally changes your emotion. It tears and rips up your gut, so you can't produce the hormones and stuff from your gut. So it numbs me, dude. It Dexter style numbs my ass, dude. I'm serious. That's why on Dexter, he talks about being numb and emotionless. And I mean, he's a killer, but we're not talking about that aspect. But he's just numb and emotionless, and it's because of coffee. He eats the eggs every morning. Shows him eating eggs every morning, and then the cup of coffee. Abraham Lincoln had cups of coffee and eggs. But I'm telling you, that cup of coffee, it wipes out everything that makes you human, and it numbs you. And that's how people can do horrific things. And the elite, all the way up, they got the coffee in the morning, then they got their liquor at night, you know? I'm not saying all the way up. There's probably... There's got to be like people up even higher than that that are like, that know that we can't use these products. You know, these are designed for the general public just to manipulate and control them. Cocomelon. Yeah, I don't know. Cocomelon's cool. Are you ready? Let's dance. But yeah, so everything, guys, watch everything you put in your body. They're putting sugar in everything nowadays. They're putting monosodium glutamate in everything. It's a drug, salt, drug, neurotoxin, salt that tricks your body into thinking that you're full. MSG, monosodium glutamate. Okay? That shit fucking is a meat tenderizer. Okay? It's a fucking neurotoxin drug in the food. Food and drug administration. Come on, let's start putting two and two together here. Come on. All your foods that are mainstream pushed have drugs in them. All your mainstream media has psychological fear and drugs in them. All your fucking water, the water probably has drugs in it too. That's why you gotta fucking filter the water, okay? So food, drugs, and then drugs, alcohol, marijuana. I don't know. Alcohol is bad, I think, for the most part. Yeah. Marijuana, there's still like a lot of discussion, and like the jury's out on that, I think. But the masses have spoken, like they're legalizing it everywhere, like, and there's like pussies like me that can't take any amount of marijuana. They get freaking crazy, right? So they got a new thing called Delta 8. That's where they take all the really heavy Delta 9 and Delta 10 THCs out. They leave the CBD and like the other healing aspects of it. And Delta 8 supposedly is like the mildest THC. And so they can actually sell this in North Carolina, South Carolina, stuff like that. And so, like I said, pussies like me that just can't handle. I mean, we're too ADHD or like, I don't know. Like when I looked up Delta 8 marijuana, it said like it's supposed to balance you. So maybe because I can't take it, marijuana, I was so out of balance where I can't feel good. I was getting stressed out. I want to jump out a window when I take it. Listening to too much heavy metal and just get the fuck out of Dodge and just like drink. I'm trying to take a freaking painkiller. When I'm on marijuana, I fucking drink too much. Fucking listen to too much music. And then like a couple days later, my wife's like, what the fuck? Are you still there? Back in the day. And I'm like, yeah, so I've graduated out of that, just being fucking gone every day. It's kind of fun. I like the music, but there's a reason why I can't do that anymore. But yeah, T, shout out to T Crypto Spot. Fucking listen to T Crypto Spot. Get your info from him, dude. He's a fucking, he's the nerd in the right way. He's not a bad nerd. He's a good nerd, dude. T Crypto Spot, fucking Jungle Inc, Staple Crew. Oh, there's a whole bunch, dude. There's a whole bunch. Go look at. Yeah. A whole bunch. So, okay, back to it. Everything you ingest will control you. Everything you own controls you. Okay? Caffeine, white sugar is a stimulant. White sugar spikes you up and hits your pleasure centers like in a not normal way, right? Okay? And then the foods and the drugs in the food, okay? So you got to eat as clean as possible, guys. You got to drink a lot of water. I think marijuana's okay. Like, if I could actually figure out a balance with that, maybe I'll use that in the future, but I'm cool with marijuana. Kratom, you only use kratom if you're wanting to get off pain pills and hardcore stuff. Kratom is sold all over the place. It's a natural plant opioid, okay? CBD is from marijuana. You use CBD when you've had too much caffeine during the day and you need to get the caffeine the fuck out of your head. You need to relax. The CBD wipes your brain clean of the caffeine, lets you relax. Because the caffeine has a half-life of like 6 to 8 hours. It'll stick inside your brain, make your heart fucking, you know? Caffeine fucking, it doesn't give you energy, guys. It fucking exploits your body to make you feel like you have energy. It makes you work harder. So caffeine is a central nervous system stimulant that forces your heart to work harder and pump harder, right? Because what happens is you have vasodilation. Vasodilation is when your blood vessels shrink and get smaller, right? So the plumbing pipes are getting smaller. So the thing that is pumping water has to work way harder to get water through, right? Because the pipes are smaller. If the pipes were big as fuck, like, it would just be flowing like nothing, right? But when we do vasoconstrictors like caffeine, there's other ones, caffeine, vasoconstrictor. Okay. So caffeine is the only vasoconstrictor I can think of right now, but vasodilators, that's another thing that's going the opposite way. You'll feel energy from that as well. So like raw cacao beans, chocolate, but in its raw form before it was heated and destroyed, before the thiobromine was destroyed, you have caffeine and coffee, thiobromine and chocolate. Okay, the thiobromine is the vasodilator. It opens up the blood vessels in your head. Okay, when you open up the pipes, make the pipes bigger, the blood can flow a lot easier. So it's a stimulant in a different way. You know, we're used to stimulants like squeeze and make the heart work harder, right? You know, but thiobromine open up the pipes and then the heart can just pump the blood through and it's just hopping and skipping, having fun, you know? So that's a different kind of stimulant. Ginseng does the same thing, opens up the blood vessels. Any kind of spices like, I don't know, like, what is it? Chili peppers and paprika and stuff like that, and freaking hot peppers. Like, they open up the blood vessels. They vasodilate. They do a good thing for you, because, and then the blood can just work, flow better and stuff like that. So there's different ways to get stimulated. Baby, that's dangerous. That's dangerous, baby. What are you doing?
Hey! Woo-hoo. Hi! Are you ready?
Coco Melon.
Let's dance!
Okay, can we sit down? Thank you. I don't like it when she stands up. Okay, all right, so. Uppers, downers, lefters, righters, vasodilators, vasoconstrictors, okay. Sugar, sugar's kind of different. You know, we have to have sugar to live. But what they've done is they've taken all the white sugar out. They've sifted it out into this really white powder, you know, kind of like cocaine, where it's really compact and your body needs energy, but your body is not smart enough to know that when you put sugar in your body, like it's not like, oh, this is way too much, way too fast. There's no like little police that I know of that are like, hey, slow that down. No, that sugar freaking is a central nervous system stimulant. It's like putting rocket fuel in your Ford Focus, right? You know what I'm saying? Like, how far can you go like that? You're gonna freaking, the Ford Focus was designed to go, I don't know, like 150 miles an hour. And then the rocket fuel is gonna make it go 200 miles an hour. And you could do that like all the way to Los Angeles and back. But like what you don't see is like all these grinding parts under the hood and stuff. That's not stuff in your body that wasn't designed to work like that, to work with this high fructose corn syrup, right? That's a fucking just synthesized condensed version of a sugar from corn that's really easy to produce. And it's just like the sugar, and I mean, it causes, our foods are drugged with high fructose corn syrup to put our bodies out of balance and give us diseases like diabetes. Okay, so then we go to the doctor, we get diabetes medicines and stuff like that, and that feeds that system. Okay, so the Food and Drug Administration, it's not designed to give you the true information, because what? 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 What?
Hi,